Rach Martin and Ryan Dingle. She lived the passion and love. Hi, Namia, how are you?
Good.
Hi, Ryan, how are you?
Yeah, good.
Could you tell us a little bit about you, please, Namia?
Yes, big deal. Yes, right now I'm in Australia, and I've been traveling like 10 months ago when I left Spain, and I'm in the way to Alice Springs.
Mm-hmm. What do you do? What's your mission?
Right now, I've been like, what I think that I came to do here in the earth is just dance and work with babies. I would like to help the women to give birth. Mm-hmm. And anyway, how I know that what I want to do is like just build a community. Now just I want to dedicate my life to joy and to just do whatever I really love to do.
What kind of community? What kind of people?
This I have to check it out, but I would like to do a kind of community that is fully in contact with the earth, where the houses are like kind of camouflage to the atmosphere of the nature, in the way that if you go like far away, you even cannot see that these people living there. And of course, in a sustainable way and respectful for the earth and for the healing and to create spaces for the art and express.
Mm-hmm. What about you, Ryan? How are you?
Yeah, I'm good. Yeah, I'm a musician and I do a lot of work with the kids. I was brought up by an indigenous man, so I work with a lot of indigenous youth and learn a lot of indigenous songs and language.
Australian indigenous?
Australian and North America.
Uh-huh.
North America as well. So I've been traveling for a few years now, and I guess uncovering like just the meaning of music, you know, going back to the roots of like the ancient, the indigenous ways of song, and just fully being in nature and just really singing the songs, you know.
Feel the passion.
And then it's been growing my music so much, and more people have been feeling it more, and then working with the kids has been opening my heart with lots of joy. And then it's just been really, really beautiful, you know, to be there. It's sort of like my job, like what I feel is to be, when I go to a place, to leave it better than when I came there. So I just travel around and play music and be there for the children and the communities. And then, yeah, just live.
And spread a world of peace.
Yeah.
Everywhere. And you know what? Last Saturday, when I've been here with you, because it was a private party. I felt really amazing, you know, I felt the energy, the passion of everyone. I saw you dancing, because when we finish the interview, we are going to see the video. Could you tell us, what does it mean, that kind of dancing? Because I saw you moving all your hands, your body, you've been in the floor. What does it mean? What's that message?
First of all, before the dance comes the vibration. And the vibration is the sound, and then you can build the melody.
You know what? I want to sing like you.
Yeah, of course.
And you start feeling that energy.
Yes. Mm-hmm. And for me, what is really important is just the music, and that's why I think that I connect really strongly with Ryan, because I love the music that he does, and just like, I enjoy because just I let myself completely free, and even I don't know what I do, and I just like let the music feel it in every cell of my body.
And feeling free. What does it mean, feeling free? Because
connecting with the elements.
Uh-huh.
That's really important. Connecting with the earth, connecting with the fire, the air, the water, yourself, the soul.
Being you, nobody else.
Oh, becoming all. Yes.
What does it mean, becoming all? So it means you are you, and then other people. What does it mean? Could you explain that, please?
Sometimes even when I dance, I feel like I'm dancing the pain of the earth, or sometimes I'm feeling like disappear, or sometimes I feel like I'm running with different energies of different animals, or I'm honoring, or being grateful, and I'm just There are a dance in Mexico, that Azteca dance, that they dance for 3 years. For 3 days. Mm-hmm. And they don't get tired because they are exchanging energy with the earth. You are giving and then you are absorbing. And even with the universe.
Yeah, because everything is energy.
Yes.
What about you, Ryan? I saw you singing. Oh my God, what kind of passion at that moment?
I don't know. I don't really think when I play. When I play, it's meditation, but even more than that. It's exactly like Namiya, where like I feel the earth's rhythm, and it feels like it, like just as Namiya is giving like the dance of the earth, like I'm giving the voice of the earth. And then for me, it's like fully connecting, like, and just beyond myself, and like to that full connection that we are of the same blood. There's the tree people are connected to us, and fully feeling that connection and resonating that. So every word that I say, people can feel it. Mm. And so then people can feel that connection, and then they feel
I
that
I felt
connection.
That night.
Thank you.
It's like all of us are one. All of us love each other.
Yeah.
It was amazing. I got a question. It's a guy from Honduras, I think. Please, I would like you answer this question for them. Is Ernesto from Honduras. He says, I'm 17 years old and I feel depressed and disappointed with my parents because my projects and feelings in life don't count for them. They just want me to study architecture and I don't want to become an architect. I would like to live my passion and purpose in life. I would like to become a singer, but my parents always tell me that I'm a loser and they are threatening me to put me away from my house. What can I do, please? Namiya, could you tell us something? Any advice, please, for Ernesto?
A lot of things to tell, but for one side, I think he has to trust himself and connect with himself and believe in him and to understand.
Believe in him.
Yes.
It's very important, belief.
Yes.
If we believe in us, everything is possible.
For the other side, what I feel is like sometimes it's hard because we need like our parents as a strong reference and supporting us. But in really what I feel is like that the sounds came to the earth to help the parents. And for one side, it's like sometimes I feel like I was me like guiding my parents how to be parents and trying to find a balance with this to let them be parents as well. And one moment.
What happened in your case? Because you told me before that your parents didn't understand you.
What happens to me when I was 18, just I was doing the high school and a lot of things was going on in my life and I couldn't like concentrate with study. Normally I always loved like study and go to school, but I was like, I didn't pass any of the themes of the course that I done and I just I leave the course because I had to do like this really introspective travel with myself to understand what I'm doing here and what I want to go, where I want to go, and what I want to do.
Why do you feel this? Why do you feel emotionally no 100%? Why? What happened? It's because your parents? What happened?
In that time, I remember that my father like picked me out home. But in really, I went like really deep. But this deepness is what makes me like, you know, like the lotus flower is like in the dirty places and then florece and grows. And that's what happens to me was like cut all and say to the life, stop, I need to check it out what I want to do here and then start to build and rebuild. And I really think that it's no worries. What I really recommend to him is go for his dreams. And that's the theme that we wanted to talk about, the purpose. what I discovered, and it's the message that I'm sending to my mom as well, is like, when you really are full aligned with your purpose, you don't have to worry about anything, because the life is like, makes the way for you work really comfortable. The thing is like, if you are not realizing your purpose, is when you will not be happy. If you are like in a office full working like 8 hours every day in front of a computer, this will not make you happy. And because this is not what you came to do here, and then it's, that's why you feel like you have to put a lot of effort to work and to build the things, and all is super difficult, and you have to do that. But when you stop all of this, and just like, no, I came here to do that because I enjoy and I love to do that, then more synchronicity, even you don't have to think.
Okay.
Just go.
Thank you, Namia. Thank you.
You're welcome.
What about you, Ryan? What would you say to Ernesto?
I say just follow your heart. Always just follow your heart. And if he feels those emotions that he's sad, the sadness, then that definitely like shows integrity and truth within that being an architect is not making him happy. It's hard because life gives us these things. But especially as a musician, I know that when life gives you these things, it gives you like a medium, an expression to go deepening within yourself. So that when you sing, people understand. So when he surpasses this, when people are going through the same and he's singing, he has learned this and he has understood this. So then when he sings and people are going through the same thing, they will listen beyond words, because that's what he's learned. That's what his soul has figured it out. It's a puzzle piece. And sometimes through cases like this, it feels like a storm. And it feels like everything's happening, but sometimes it's more of a gift than anything. Sometimes it illuminates, it reveals, as it just breaks away all walls and turns into a door. A door to be able to truly reveal like what passion truly is. Passion is a savior. Passion is like connection to all. And then sometimes the storm is there and it's raining. It's just cleansing away all load of architects and all these old the clouds break away, and then there it is. There's passion, there's purpose. That's who I am. I am that sun. Like, you know, like I'm gonna shine. Like, and it's hard because especially with close relations, like, and then they're telling you, and then you're trying to please people, but sometimes staying in your truth is number one. Staying in your truth, like, this is who I am. And always just following that, and always just like walking that path of integrity, but in honoring, and then they will understand.
Yeah, you're right. Sometimes people go for life trying to please everyone, even though they feel upset. Why? I don't understand. We need, as you say, we need to be us, to start living with passion.
You have to live your own life.
Yes.
You cannot live the life that the other ones wanted.
And what for?
Yes. Yeah. And that's when really you can shine, who him say, when you are living your path. And the other thing that I would like to add is one advertisement that a friend gave to me. And when you have any doubt or you have to take any decision, ask yourself, this is the way to the fear or this is the way to the love? And you will find the answer straight away. If you are doing this for fear or if you are doing this because you love to do it.
Yeah, it's true. Thank you very much. Please, to finish this amazing interview, could you give us a message to daughters, some in any age, 15, 16, 17, 18, if they don't want to live passion, if the parents are pushing them to study something that probably they don't want, what would you say, please, to the world? What would you say, Ryan, please?
What would I say? I'd just say, it's just so much poetry, feels like it's running in my veins and wants to come out, and I don't know how to like compress it into one sentence. Well, what I say is that the winds are singing for you, the trees are dancing for you, the animals are running in your veins, in your blood. All is perfect, but all you have to do is be you. And sometimes it's hard going through like different systems and stuff, but the number one key is believing, trusting, loving, forgiving.
Forgiving. Thank you for saying that, because many people don't ask for forgiveness. We need to forgive or ask for this. Thank you. Thank you, Ryan. What about you, Nemia? What would you say to the world? They are listening to us.
For me, I will say, like, ask yourself what brings you joy, and then ask yourself, what do you would like to learn? The earth is full of amazing things. So much to see, so much to learn. And this is what you have to do once you get the answer. Go for it. We came here to be happy, to enjoy.
Thank you. Thank you. Let me congratulate you, because you are different. You know, normally we try to show different physical attitude, you know, but now you feel free. You know, and I see things like you, and I feel really good as well. Thank you. thank you very much. Thank you very much for being with us.
Yes.
Thank you very much for being with us. Please remember, be just yourself and believe in your dreams. Parents, look after the kids, but don't push them. See you next time. All the best.
Dream is reality.
Yes.
Thank you.